These Adams Maxwell machines are made in Southern California. You know, why do we wind them here in California? Well, to have the consistency of production, like this is the very same machine that's wound all these transformers over the last almost 30 years, right? What we do is we've got a piece of paper with its winding diagram. This transformer is very simple, and it, you know, declares 750 turns of whatever gauge wire that is, and they load it up onto this tensioner and bobbin here, and they pull the wire onto the bobbin. It's going to attach, the first winding is going to start at pin 1 and end at pin 5. There you go. And then they will program the number of turns. They'll program the pitch, which is how fast it's going back and forth, and they'll set the limit, you know, from whatever that is, 0 to 5/8 of an inch or whatever. They'll set that with these knobs here. So it's going back and forth, and feed as this turns, zzz, and it's pulling the wire, and it's populating the wire back and forth like this, and then it loads up that turn. Then you stop, and it says finish at pin 5. You tie it off at pin 5, and then you start the next one. Some transformers like this one, it's a very simple part. There's only 4 windings on it. Other transformers, we might have 19 windings on that are, they're a lot more complicated. This is just a 1-to-1 transformer that's used for line level in a Manley Vox box, for instance. And its job is to give you, it's not needing to remove any DC voltages off the primary. Its job is to take the output of the tube circuit, pass that through to an XLR connector in a balanced form. That's its job. So we took a single-ended signal from the output of the Vox box and gave you a balanced output through a transformer. And again, between each layer of winding, they're gonna put a layer of Mylar tape. Sometimes we use a thing called fish paper, which is a paper product. It's an insulation. Sometimes it's a Mylar tape, or there are different materials that are used inside the transformer to separate all the layers. But yeah, let's look at what happens after we've got the bobbin all wound, because we can't make anything transform quite yet without the laminations. Here's a big transformer. So once we've got this, and in this case, they've taken the layers and they've combined in serial and in parallel the different windings, and they've combined them inside, and then they brought them out on these wire leads. So they've terminated the magnet wire inside and brought them out on conventional wire leads, because that's how we're going to load this into the chassis. But we're not done yet, right? So they've wrapped up the bobbin real pretty with this cloth tape. Then they're gonna take the laminations. Now, you might have heard of toroidal transformers, and they're wound around a circular donut core. There's different core materials. There's another thing called an R core, which is kind of a combination of an EI transformer and a toroid sort of. But these are called EI transformers. And why is that? I wonder why. Why are they called EI transformers?
I have no idea.
It's really a mystery, huh? So how that works is when we're going to load in all the laminations, we're going to take our E's and we're going to load them into the tongue is here. We're going to load them in here by hand like this and alternate. So we're going to have stacks of E's on one side or another, you know, like this. And then we're going to put this one in and that one in and just da-da-da-da-da-da, stack it all up. And then after that, we're going to turn the transform on the side, and the spaces between the E's, we're going to slide the I's in so that it all solidifies. Now you ask, why don't you just take a big old block of an E and a big old block that's an I and just bolt the damn thing together? Well, that's because in magnetics, when you're putting a current through this, you'll get a current that gets set up in the lamination material. And if this were a big block of steel, you would get a lot of currents in there. They could have their own life, you know? So we use very skinny, isolated, these have a little coating on them so they're not electrically coupling to his neighbors on the floor above and below him. And that's why it's to reduce the eddy currents in the core material. That's why we don't use big bricks of steel there. We use real skinny little guys. So that's that. But that's why they're called EI transformers, because the lamination, they're stamped out of a grain-oriented steel in these shapes.